Amanda?
Yes.
How are you, darling?
I'm good.
And your relation to Neil?
Daughter.
You're his daughter?
Yes.
Now, okay, Neil named her after one of the moons of Uranus.
Uranus, I think, is how we pronounce it.
No, Uranus is the thing in the middle. I'm sorry about that. Two different areas, totally. Uranus is up there. Uranus is right. No one's seen that.
You could say Uranus until you're like eight, you know, and then you move.
Hey, hey, no, I'm getting tired of your ass, man. Name something a lady cop might do to her husband in the bedroom.
Cut his penis off.
This thing we're doing, this is a game show. Okay. This isn't therapy. Wow. Cut it off! Travis, how you doing?
Good, good.
Good looking kid, man, I tell you. How old are you?
16.
Okay, I got that right. What are you doing? I love the hair, man. I love the hair. What are you doing?
But you want some of that.
No. Show Mr. Fox family. Nice people, no smart asses over there. I get to the boy, bet you wish you had some, don't you? Name something a lady cop might do to her husband in the bedroom.
Cut his penis off.
This thing we're doing, this is a game show. Okay. This isn't therapy. Wow. Cut it off! All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, 20 seconds on the clock, please. Come on. We asked 100 married women, what percentage of your husband do you think is pure fat?
20%.
Besides the hips, name another body part used to twirl a hula hoop.
The arms.
Which state has the best beaches in America?
California.
Name something a cup gets filled with.
Water.
Name the busiest day of the week for banks.
Monday.
All right, let's go. We ask 100 married women, what percentage of your husband do you think is pure fat? You said a 20%. A survey said? It's pretty good. Besides the hips, name another body part used to twirl a hula hoop. You said your arms. Survey said? Which state has the best beaches in America? You said Cali. Survey said? Yeah. Name something a cup gets filled with. You said water. Survey said? Yeah. Name the busiest day of the week for banks. You said Monday. Survey said? Good job. That's pretty good. Yeah. Well, Sherry, he got 154 points. So, Sherry, all you need is 46.
Come on, Sherry.
If you don't get the 46 points, you're gonna be on YouTube.
Oh my God, these poppy pants are sticking in my brain so bad. Oh my God.
Oh, straighten God. It out.
Okay.
All right, now listen to me closely, Shirley. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
No.
No. Let's remind everybody Chris's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. All right, let's go. Come on, Sherry, let's win this money. We asked 100 married women, what percentage of your husband do you think is pure fat?
70.
Besides the hips, name another body part used to twirl a hula hoop.
Booty.
Name, which state has the best beaches in America?
California.
Try again.
Miami.
Name something a cup gets filled with.
Water.
Try again.
Cup gets filled with orange juice.
Name the busiest day of the week for banks.
Monday.
Try again.
Friday.
Let's just hope that last one saved it. We asked 100 women, married women, what
I'm not married.
Yeah, well, your answer will reflect that. What percentage of your husband do you think is pure fat? You said. Survey said. Number one answer was 20%. We still need 46 points. Besides the hips, name another body part used to twirl a hula hoop. You said, yo, booty. That's a good one. Survey said, waist and stomach was number one. We're 42 points away. Which state has the best beaches in America? And you said, Miami. Survey said, sure hope this last one saved you. Number one answer was Florida. It's in Florida. It's come on, Sherry. Name something a cup gets filled with. You said, orange juice. Survey said, water. Water was number one answer. Name the busiest day of the week for banks. You said, Friday. Survey said, Friday. Friday was the number one answer. $25,000 for the Summit View School. $25,000 for the Summit View School. I'd like to thank Sherry and Ian and their family for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. Stay tuned, everybody. Two new families when Celebrity Family Feud continues. You ready? JoJo's off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. 20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 men, if you had a butler, what would you ask him to bring you right now?
A beer.
What do you do on a day when you have nothing to do?
Sleep.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is your cooking?
A 10.
Name something with stripes.
A prison uniform.
Fill in the blank. Blank conditioner.
Shampoo and conditioner.
Right.
All right.
Okay. All right. Let's see what we got here. We asked 100 men, if you had a butler, what would you ask him to bring you right now? You said, give me a beer. Survey said. What do you do on a day when you have nothing to do? You said, sleep. Survey said. Right. On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is your cooking? You said, 10. I bet it is. Survey says.
Okay.
All right.
Name something with stripes. You said.
Jaws,
damn. Rock. Prison uniform. Survey said.
That's good.
Fill in the blank. Blank conditioner. You said shampoo and conditioner. Survey said.
All right.
Wow. Really good.
I am excited. I am terrified.
I got my good luck charm.
That's the exact size of my head. That's scary. I'm actually looking at that going, damn. All right. Your mom, Jess, got 152 points.
I told you we'd play this game a lot.
You play it, we need 48 and you can win it all.
No pressure.
48, yeah. No pressure. Let's remind everybody of Jess's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, good luck charm, do your thing. We asked 100 men, if you had a butler, what would you ask him to bring you right now?
Beer.
Try again.
Food.
What do you do on a day when you have nothing to do?
Sleep.
Try again.
Jeez, Mom. Play on my phone all day.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is your cooking?
8.
Name something with stripes.
With stripes? Pants.
Fill in the blank.
Zebra.
Fill in the blank. Blank conditioner.
Hair.
Try again.
Shampoo and.
It's okay, let's go.
Shampoo and conditioner.
Same answer.
All right, we need 48 points for the money. We asked 100 men, if you had a butler, what would you ask him to bring you right now? You said, food. Survey said, and beverage was number one. What do you do on a day when you have nothing to do? You said, play on the phone.
Zero.
Survey said. Sleep was the number one answer.
And 8's good.
We need 2 points. On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is your cooking? You said, we need 8.
Come on, 8!
Survey said. Oh, yeah!
Hey!
All right, you ready?
Nope.
Okay. First time, that's threw me off a little bit, huh? Well, we're gonna put 20 seconds on the clock. All right, here we go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it.
Water.
Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married.
25.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year.
Flowers.
Name something children write with.
Crayons.
Name a way that Bigfoot's feet might be different from yours.
Huge.
Wow.
Let's go, girl.
All right, let's go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it. You said, water. Survey said.
Yeah.
Tell me the age a woman might say is a perfect age to get married. You said, 25. Survey said.
Yeah.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year. You said, flowers, survey said. Yeah. Name something children write with, you said. Crayons, survey said. Yeah. Name a way that Bigfoot's feet might be different from yours, you said. They're huge, survey said. Yeah. Oh. Okay, I'll tell you what. I got some good news and I got some bad news. Which one you want first?
I gotta go with the good news first.
Go with the good news. Your wife put up a really, really big number.
Okay.
Now here's the bad news. If you don't get this, you out to leave. Go ahead. You need 6 points. For you, Steph, that's 2 shots.
Come on.
Step over half and let it go. Ready?
I guess so. Let's do it.
All right, let's remind everybody of Aisha's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it.
Water.
Try again.
Milk.
Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married.
25.
Try again.
30.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year.
Pass.
Name something children write with.
Pencil.
Name a way that Bigfoot's feet might be different from your feet.
They're bigger.
Try again.
Hairier.
Yeah. That's good enough. Let's go. All right, let's go. We need 6 points. She nailed it. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it. You said milk.
Come on.
Survey said.
What? Was it wine?
Alcohol, man. Alcohol.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Water. Water was the number one answer. Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married. You said 30. Survey said. You ready to have a good time? All right, let's go. Let's get it on. Give me Lance. Give me Kelly. Let's go.
Shaking my booty.
Yeah.
I can't believe we're doing this. I'm gonna like do your.
Yeah. Two hands or one?
I don't know. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Y'all, okay, one hand.
Here we go.
Okay, hold on.
Pull yourself together. Okay. Come on, let's have this moment here. Come on. Let's get on into it. This is your moment.
You're gonna have to subtitle this episode. We're so southern.
This is it. This is your moment here.
Okay,
nice shoes like that.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Okay, hold on.
Top 6 answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name something specific that only your man is allowed to do to your behind. Okay. You scared the shit out of me.
This is like reinforced.
No. What the hell had happened? I thought you was falling. I went. Okay. Lance.
Yes. Give it a little pinch.
Give it a little pinch.
That's right.
Kelly.
I should say it.
Yeah, you do. Just
gotta
do it.
Say it.
Like a little spank. Oh, a little pat.
Give it a little spank.
Thank you.
And for those of y'all that ain't from the country, she said spank. Give it a little spank. Oh. 2 syllables from us in the country. Spank. But it's just spank.
My translator.
Give it a little spank. Yeah, we're gonna play. Thomas, only 1 strike. If it were up to men, what would their bride be wearing as she walked down the aisle?
I'll keep her comfortable in some tennis shoes.
Some tennis shoes.
Yeah, up to the man, baby.
My wife got on tennis shoes right now.
Hey, more support, I don't know.
Cliff, you tried to support him on that
just
one.
A little bit.
Good answer.
It ain't up there.
And you say your wife got on tennis shoes right now. Yeah, well, that's good. Well, she ain't walking down the aisle right now. So. Ain't nobody asked you what she had on now, Thomas. We trying to win the damn game. That's what we trying to do. That was a good, safe answer, though. Appreciate that. You've been married for how long?
8 years next week.
Yeah. Oh, congratulations. So you got to give Thomas a little credit on this answer right here. This is a married man's answer. This is when all the good stuff is gone. You don't want her to know You don't want her to know how tricky your mind really is. So you say something that can get you safely back in the house. Tennis shoes. For those of you who keep wondering why I don't turn and point to every answer, if I know that it ain't up there, why am I pulling my shirt out of my pants, messing up my look for an answer like tennis shoes? All right, family. Here we go. Name something Grandma might do if she caught Grandpa smoking marijuana.
The family says, sell it. Not me, I say keep it, they say sell it.
Distribute it? Snoop said, not me, I said keep it. The hell would you? Grandma hustling, selling dope down there in Crenshaw. Grandma is selling dope. Number six. Oh. I told y'all, I had this. We ain't hooking up in the huddle no more. It's reefer, ask me. That can ruin a kiss.
I want to hear a lot of reaction out of you, all right?
Got it.
Chapped lips. Oh! Yeah, Steve! Yeah!
See, you need the support of your family, Gene.
I want your support right now, Steve.
No, man. No, you can't get none of that from me. No, not on that. I ain't here for support. I'm just here for jokes. I'm here to take what you said and feed it back to you. Chap lips. How many think it's up there? Yeah. Chap lips.
Explanation for that, Steve?
Steve, what is that? Yeah.
What? If I'm gonna leave this show as a loser today, I would just like to know, what is a booty tootie? Just fill me in on that. You could.
I'm interested to know.
I don't know.
I'm confused over here.
Okay, well, the entire minority population is confused.
What's a booty tootie?
The blacks and browns have come together and finally. And looking at my rest of my audience out here, white people don't know what the hell that is either. So finally, we have found a common ground. None of us know what the hell booty tootie is. I mean, no one knows. Yes, ma'am. A fart.
Oh, whoa!
Oh, fart.
Okay.
Is it a fart?
That's a weird name.
So this is a teenage white girl answer? She is the only one who knew that. The grown-ups in here was going, what the hell? Wow, a fart. Number two.
A bird.
Give me Ray. Give me James. Was I? No, I'm the host. Steve don't do no right. I done seen this before. You don't get in the middle of heavyweights when they doing what they do. They hit too hard. If they accidentally hit you, it's gone. It's Christmas. It's Christmas. We ain't even had Easter yet. It's Christmas. All right, let's go, fellas. Point values are double. We got the top six answers on the board. We ask 100 men, name something you do when you realize you run out of clean underwear. James.
Clean up and get new ones. Buy some new ones.
It doesn't matter the new ones.
Buy some new ones.
I got you. You can buy some new ones. Ray.
Go commando.
Go commando.
We're playing.
We're gonna play. Yeah. There we go. Ooh, I was scared. This could have went so bad. Huh? I was talking about hell, I can't whoop nobody up here. I was gonna try to point to somebody, but I can't whoop nobody up here.
Steve, you can't whoop you can't whoop nobody over here, but over there, no problem.
No, Jen, there might be no problem for you. I can't whoop nobody over here. You can't cash that check.
You can take the check over there and cash it.
Where's the bank? What bank?
Don't worry, Steve, you safe. You safe, Steve. We got your back, baby. Don't worry about
you
it.
You do, you got my back. You got my back, gang.
I'm always in the back.
Cause he the coach. Come on, Ray, please don't. Please don't get him started. It's a nice family gang, kids is watching. I gotta.
Ooh.
Y'all supposed to huddle up. Well, don't worry about it. Don't.
Oh my God. This is
boy, do I miss just regular old families.
Oh, man.
Ladies, point values are double. We got top five answers on the board. Name something that people stick their noses into. Essence.
The apple bucket.
The what?
The apple bucket, like bobbing for apples.
Where did
did that answer come from?
If I had to take two, it would be better. It would be better if I had to take two.
Yeah.
I love you too.
Yeah, you love her. Yeah, yeah.
You know what?
No, I'm gonna say it's okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, here we go. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm ready.
In the apple bucket.
Oh my God. It's all right. It's all right.
After you said it, I saw the look on your face.
Yeah.
After you said, in the apple bucket, you went. Okay.
Yeah. In someone's business.
In someone's business. $5,000 into that football league for you. All right? This is how we're gonna do it, Snoop. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. They got it right. Hey, that sound right. He knew right where it went on time. I'll say try again, then you give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Robin's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. We asked 100 women, how much does your purse weigh?
3 pounds.
Name a salad dressing you'd find at most salad bars.
Ranch.
Try again.
French.
Name something that happens in the month of April.
April Fools.
Fill in the blank, pie in the what?
Horse.
Name a color in a traffic light.
Red.
Yeah. Let's go, Snoop. Sure hope we get down to that one, because I don't know what the hell you said, but sure hope we make it to that one. We need 59. We ask 100 women, how much does your purse weigh? You said 3 pounds. Survey said 5 pounds was the number one answer. We need 51. Name a salad dressing you find at most salad bars. You said French. Survey said? All right. Ranch was the number one answer. We need 30 points. Name something that happens in the month of April. You said? Yeah. April Fool's Day. Survey said? Well, sometimes God hears and answers prayers. I now get to find out what the hell he said. We need 1 point. Fill in the blank. Pie in the what the hell did you say? What? Pie in the horse. Folks, when your brain cells have your brain cells have suffered a little bit. You're gonna have moments like this. This is going to be on YouTube. 'Cause Snoop just said, pie in the horse. The hell is he talking about? We need 1 point. I need one other person in this world who, for some reason, has found a pie stuck up inside a horse, cut it, and served it to the people. Survey says, yes. We need 1 point. Name a color in a traffic light. You said red. Survey said. Yeah. Sugar Ray, Snoop Dogg, and their families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time. And get yourself some pie in the horse. Come on, Chuck, we can do it, though. You ready?
I'm ready.
You got 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love?
3.
Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight.
Jersey.
Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue.
Charcoal.
Fill in the blank, fortune blank.
500.
Name a drink that's served both hot and cold.
Tea.
Good answer.
Yeah. This might be all right. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love? You said 3. Survey said? Yeah. Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight. You said the jersey. Survey said? Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue. You said charcoal, survey said. Yep. Fill in the blank, fortune blank. You said fortune 500, survey said. Yeah. Name a drink to serve both hot and cold. You said tea, survey said. Oh, yeah. Here comes Shaq.
Yeah. How Chuck did, he do
Chuck right? Did all right, man. Chuck got 134 points. Yeah. Yeah. You need 66, Diesel. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Chuck's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. All right, here we go. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love?
4.
Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight.
Pads.
Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue.
Barbecue sauce.
Fill in the blank, fortune blank.
500.
Try again.
Fortune cookie.
Name a drink that's served both hot and cold.
Tea.
Try again.
Coffee.
It's over.
You won?
It's over. About to see. Normally, I put my arm around the person, but this ain't gonna look good. That was a very uncomfortable moment. All right, we need 66 points. Let's go. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love? You said 4. Survey said. One. One was the number one answer.
One?
Oh, hell no.
You know they tired of you. Stop all this. Four times, three times, man. Come on. Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight. You said? Vance. Survey said? Diesel, we 9 points away. Number one answer was pants. Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue. You said, you need barbecue sauce. He can't even start without knowing where the damn sauce is. Damn the grill, charcoal, Where the hell is the sauce? Survey said. Was the number one answer. They had all of them. Well, that's $25,000 for the Mustard Seed School. I'd like to thank Ernie and Jimmy and the rest of everybody, all of you guys, for coming out and joining us on Celebrity Family Feud. Welcome back to Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. The Kardashian family once again. And now it's time to play. For the first time in the history of Family Feud, we have an announcement. Chloe?
Well, Kim and Kanye were dying to do this, and they really thought they were gonna win. They didn't, but as sisters, Kendall and I are deciding to let them play Fast Money because it's going to the same charity.
Yeah! So they're gonna step aside, because it's always been Yeezy's dream to play Fast Money. So Kanye West and Kim West are gonna play Fast Money. Who's playing first? Come on, Kim.
I am so nervous. I practice this in my bedroom every single night, but I think in person I'm gonna hopefully not do awful because the charity needs it.
Well, here's the thing. It's hard to practice for this game.
Yes, I know.
Because I'm gonna ask you some stuff that's way more ridiculous than what you've practiced for. It's hard to practice for ignorance. It really is.
Okay. Children's Hospital, Los Angeles, this is for you.
Yay! Okay. I'm gonna give you a chance. So, Kim, this is it. This is for my man, Yeezy. He's off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Kanye together come up with 200 points. Look right there and tell him what you're playing for.
$25,000 for the Children's Hospital, Los Angeles.
Yeah. All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please.
Okay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Name a part. okay, stop. Okay, stop.
Back.
No. We gonna start off. You just had to get the same answer. I was stunned at the question.
Okay.
Just do it. Yeah, you are. Okay, we could just get the same answer.
Okay.
I have 20 seconds on the clock. You ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Name a part of the body you're always banging into things.
Your butt.
Fill in the blank. Slice of what?
Pie.
Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing.
Running in the wheel.
Name something you need to make a milkshake.
Milk.
Bam. Woo! Bam. Bam. All right.
I did it.
Let's see. All right, here we go. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? You said, I'm a 10. I've never said I was a 10, ever. Survey said,
Yeah. Name a part of the body you're always banging into things. You said your butt. Am I grinning that hard?
No, I've really like knocked things over with my butt before. So this is really true for me.
Bam. Survey said. What?
What? It's all right.
Here we go, fill in the blank. Slice of what? You said pie. Survey said. That's a good one. Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing. You said running on a wheel. Survey said? Yeah. Name something you need to make a milkshake. You said milk. Survey said? Wow. Good comeback. Can win $25,000 for his charity. Coming up, let's bring Kanye out, see if he can win this $25,000. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? Your wife said 10. You said 10. Then you said. Welcome back to Celebrity Family Feud. Let's bring Kanye out, see if he can win this $25,000. Let's go, Ye. All right, we in business. Wifey did pretty good. Couple of stunning answers, but she did good. Your girl got 147 points. Ooh. Kanye, we need 53. We need 53 for the money. This is gonna be good. All right, this is how we gonna do it. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kim's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Try again.
5.
Name a part of the body you're always banging into things.
Your knee.
Fill in the blank, slice of what?
Bread.
Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing.
Being on a spinning wheel.
Try again.
Eating.
Name something you need to make a milkshake.
Milk.
Try again.
Ice cream.
Bam. Come on, Blake. Yeah. Come on. Come on, let's go. We need 53 points for $25,000. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? Your wife said 10. You said 10. Then you said 5. Survey said 5 and 8 was tied for the top answer. We're 32 away. Name a part of the body you're always banging into things. You said your knee. Survey said. Oh! Yeah, boy. Leg and knee was the number one answer. Pie was the number one answer. Running on the wheel, the number one answer. Milk was the number one answer. They had all the number ones. That's $25,000 for Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. I'd like to thank Kanye, Kim, Chris, and the rest of the family for coming out on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud. Let's meet our next two families from Stranger Things. It's Gaten, Matarazzo, and family playing for CCD Smiles. And we've got dance prodigy Maddie Ziegler, pop star Kenzie Ziegler, and family playing for My Friend's Place. You want to play some Feud? Let's get it on. Give me Gaten. Give me Maddie. Okay, y'all done worked it out. I see.
Yeah.
Y'all ready?
I am.
All right, let's go. We got top seven answers on the board. Name a fruit a teenager might practice the art of kissing on.
A peach?
A peach. Gaten?
An apple?
An apple. Pass or play?
We'll play it.
We're gonna play.
Yeah. All right, Gaten.
Gaten, let me ask you something.
Yes, sir?
That's the number one answer.
Yes, sir.
Now, the little young lady pulled up peach. You just fired out the number one apple. You know something about that? Just checking.
All right.
I'm just talking about what's over there. All right. We're about what's over there. Come on, Gaten, get your mind right, baby. All right, Dad, here we go. Name a fruit a teenager might practice art of kissing on.
Strawberry.
Strawberry. Big Daddy Swag. Name a fruit a teenager might practice the art of kissing on.
A lemon. You gotta pucker up. Uh-huh. You gotta puck her up.
Yeah. You gotta puck. I got you.
You gotta puck her
on
up.
A limit. Yeah. I like that. Sabrina, name a fruit a teenager might practice the art of kissing on.
How about an orange?
An orange.
Yeah. Good answer. There we go. That's it.
All right. Hey, Vicky.
Hi.
Name a fruit teenager might practice the art of kissing on.
A cantaloupe?
In the world? Good answer.
I don't know if it's big, it's round, I don't know.
All right, little Vicky. Let's do some cantaloupe kissing. Hey, Gaten, only one strike, man. Name a fruit a teenager might practice art of kissing on.
Steve. Forgive me.
No, go ahead.
I'm gonna say banana.
Oh. All right, Nate.
Come on!
Very good.
It had to be said.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you something.
Yes, sir.
Gaten, let me tell you something.
All right. I'm scared.
Boy. I sure hope that's up there.
I do too. I'm praying. I'm so praying.
It's exactly what I was thinking.
Yeah, right?
Banana! Dad, we got one answer left. You can clear the board. This is your chance to make up for that strawberry. Name a fruit a teenager might practice the art of kissing on.
I can't think of anything else. Pineapple.
All right, it's good. It was good. There's not much left.
I'm running out of food.
There's not much left, Steve.
There's not much left. Leave it for Dad. Thank you.
Where on a pineapple would you want to put your tongue? That little prickly, hard pineapple.
It's okay. There's not much left.
We got one answer left. We got to be careful because you got two strikes. The Ziegler Cassoni family can steal.
Grapefruit.
Big Daddy Swag say grapefruit.
All right, come on.
Mango.
Ladies, here's your chance. Name a fruit a teenager might practice all the kissing on.
Mango.
Number 7. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. Give me RuPaul. Give me Katie. Top 8 answers on the board. Let's just go and get the party started. Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without...
Oh, I did it so fast, didn't I? Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without him thinking that she's a whore. That's what I'm thinking you're gonna say. That's what I think. Yeah. So I'm gonna go with that. My answer is. It is by batting her eyelashes.
I think we're playing.
This is not how you play the game. By batting her eyelashes. Come on, man, let's just play.
We're gonna play!
Oh, my God! So I guess she's gonna finish asking the question, right? Yeah, all right.
Great job, by the way.
Thank you.
You're like psychic, too.
Well, Carson, I've been in that situation so many times.
I bet.
Same.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Same.
Yeah.
Why am I here today?
Well.
Why don't you just let RuPaul host the damn show?
Why am I here today? You're here because of all of this toasted plum. That's why you're here. All that toasted plum.
I'm not wearing this damn suit no more. I'm telling you right now. Get all your pictures. This goes into retirement right after this. I'm gonna put it in a glass case. This was the night I was toasted plum. Ladies and gentlemen, Michelle Visage right here.
Yes! Visage.
This is Michelle Visage right here.
Yeah.
She is a judge on RuPaul's Drag Race and on Ireland and Got Talent.
Yes.
She's a bad girl.
Yes.
Also, was a morning radio host. Really?
I competed with you when you were on the beat in Los Angeles.
Ooh. Yeah. Don't worry about it. I ran everybody out of L.A.
He actually did.
Yeah.
Number one.
He actually did.
Yeah, I was strong out here, man.
It was me and Sinbad, remember?
Oh, you did it with Sinbad?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
No, you don't.
No, I do. No.
Nobody does. It's all
no,
good.
No, really, but I spanked Sinbad.
Yeah, you did.
I sure did.
Thank you for that.
But he's my buddy, though.
So. I spanked him, too, but it wasn't on the radio.
Let me clear this up right now.
I don't know that
he did not spank Sinbad. I'm defending him. Sinbad ain't here. He has not spanked Sinbad.
It was a different Sinbad, I think.
It ain't even his turn. It's not his turn.
It's gonna be a long day.
Okay, here's the question.
What's the actual question?
I don't. He got the number one answer.
That's why Ruse
Wink. Wink eye, bang him.
I bang.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I'm from the hood. I just saw bang him. I went down.
All right, here's the actual question. Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
How about smile?
Oh, that's wholesome.
That was very wholesome.
Okay, yeah. Michelle.
What?
You see a man.
Mm?
You want to flirt with it. Give me the smile.
I can't eye bang.
Yeah, give me the smile.
So you gotta...
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. That's right. I'm walking right over there.
Thank you.
Know that.
Thank you.
Yeah, yes.
With cash in hand.
I'm 63. I qualify as a sugar daddy. Yeah, that's it. Already know that. Smile. Ladies and gentlemen, Carson Kressley.
Yay!
He's back. He's one of the judges on RuPaul's Drag Race, and he's one of the original Fab Five on Queer Eye.
Yes, that's me. Yeah, that's all true.
Now, the term for the original five on Queer Eye is OGs.
Yes, old gays.
Which I didn't know.
No, it's... Original gangster.
Oh.
Yeah.
Edgy.
Yeah.
Edgy.
Original gangster.
Yeah.
Woo! Look out.
All right, Carson.
Yes.
Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
Oh, I've heard of this thing called sexting, where you send a sassy message on your phone.
Oh. Oh. Yes. All the cool kids.
Sexting.
Yeah.
Good answer. Yes! 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 Good job.
Ladies and gentlemen, Latrice Royale. Contestant on Drag Race and won Miss Congeniality title. Really? And one of the 100 most powerful drag queens in America. Okay. When they say 100 most powerful, what do they mean?
Look at me.
I'm sorry. Oh.
Yes, Mama Trees.
I got it. God, I'm gonna admit to something too. Scared me a little bit. Scared me. Can I ask, like, how long have you been in
the biz?
In the biz.
Yeah.
27 years.
Wow.
And I'm only 29.
So good.
But because of political correctness, I believe you. Give it up for 29, everybody. Looks absolutely beautiful, don't you agree? All right, name a way, Latrice, that a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
Maybe showing a little leg. Okay. Hiking up her skirt, a little knee.
Demonstrate, Raven.
There's another one over here.
I want to go home. I'm not going to survive this. I'm just letting you, I'm not going to survive this. This could be my last time hosting, folks. Because this right here is getting more dangerous as it goes down. Like, RuPaul's actually, like, really cool. And then, like, this is, like wonderful. And then it just starts diving. Because this damn Carson is ignorant in real life.
What?
And then Latrice Royale, look at me. That tightened everything in me up. Okay, what was your answer?
Sure, a little leg.
Sure.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
It is a good answer.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
It's up there.
Yeah, I'm gonna need you to use the voice that you use when you perform it.
Show a little leg.
All
Get your damn leg out. Get your damn leg out.
That's right.
Boo.
Ladies and gentlemen, Raven. Two-time runner-up on Drag Race and professor of RuPaul's Drag U. So two-time runner-up.
Two-time runner-up. Talk to him.
Who beat you?
Two very fierce queens beat me.
Yeah.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
It's up there.
Talk to him. And how long?
Have I been in the game?
Yes.
Well, I'm only 28 years old, and I've been doing it for 18 years.
Raven, name a way a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
I say blow him a kiss.
That's a great answer.
Yeah, we don't have to demonstrate that.
That was genius.
Blow him a kiss. RuPaul, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Now, the bold type can steal.
Yeah.
Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
I say send him a drink.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Send him a drink.
That's up there. Yeah.
Up in the club.
That's up there.
What?
All right, guys, here we go. Name a way a woman can flirt with a man without making physical contact.
We think you might give him a little dance.
I might.
You know, dancing?
Yeah, what do you mean by that?
I mean, I'm not a very good dancer, but...
I mean, but you gotta...
That's how I thought. Yeah, I don't know.
No, you stop.
I feel like...
That's not gonna get it.
But I think like a little Shakira hip swivel might.
That's good.
You know?
That's good too.
Yes. A little dance. Number 8. Yes. I'm sorry.
What? What do you mean? Get naked?
Number 5.
Talking.
4.
Oh. Ooh.
Yes. Number 3.
Come on.
Don't go away. We'll be right back when Celebrity Family Feud continues. All right, you ready? All right, 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. Name something your bedmate does in bed that should be against the law.
Snore.
In which country are men the biggest playboys?
France.
How many days could you go without sleeping?
2.
Name a food you cook for breakfast when camping out.
Eggs.
Fill in the blank. Austin blank.
Powers.
Right here we go. Name something your bedmate does in the bed that should be against the law. You said snore, survey said. Woo! In which country are the men the biggest playboys? You said France, survey said. How many days could you go without sleeping? You said 2. Survey said.
Wow. Way more than
name a food you cook for breakfast when camping out. You said some eggs. Survey said.
Don't mark that.
Fill in the blank. Austin blank. You said Austin Powers. Survey said.
Oh, my God.
I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
Which would you like first?
Bad.
The bad news. If you miss this...
Oh, wow.
This would be the biggest failure in the history of game shows.
No!
Yeah.
Oh.
Here's the good news. You only need 3 points.
Three?
Martha got...
I can't mess
the highest up. Score in the history of Celebrity Family Feud. 197 points.
Okay.
This is how this is gonna work.
Yeah.
I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. You give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready? Mm-hmm. All right, let's remind everybody of Martha's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Name something your bedmate does in the bed that should be against the law.
Snoring.
Try again.
Sweating.
In which country are men the biggest playboys?
America.
How many days could you go without sleeping?
5.
Name a food you cook for breakfast when camping out.
Bacon.
Fill in the blank. Austin blank.
Texas.
Nice! Nice!
All right, here we go. Name something your bedmate does in the bed that should be against the law. You said sweating. Survey said.
Oh, that's such a good answer.
Snoring was number one.
That was a good one.
In which country are men the biggest playboys? You said right here, USA. Survey said. Boom. Number one answers. Snores, France, 2 eggs, Austin Powers, and Texas was tied for number one. She had all number one answers. Well, that's $25,000 for the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation. I want to thank Jasmine, Wells, and the rest of you for coming out, hanging out with us on Celebrity Family Feud. Stay tuned. We got 2 new families when Celebrity Family Feud continues. Y'all ready? Let's do it. Let's meet the families. It's the West family. No introduction necessary. Yeezy. That's all it is. How you been, man?
I'm good.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
I heard that everybody's like big fans of Family Feud.
Yes.
That's all I hear. Yeah. That's really good, man. So we here, man. We're gonna get it on. How you been, man?
I've been good, you know?
You looking well?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Good, good, good. Who is this next to you? You wanna introduce? Introduce these people you bought? Who's?
Well, this is my beautiful wife, Kim Kardashian West.
What's up, Kim? Hey, darling, how you doing? Kim Kardashian, beauty, fragrance line, everything, executive producer of the new series of Glam Masters.
And the biggest Family Feud fan.
The biggest.
That's all we do. Every single night, we just watch Family Feud.
You like told me that once before.
Gotta have a feud.
That's big. And congratulations, just had your 3rd child in January. That's big. Good family right here. All right, Kanye, who else you bring with you?
This is my beautiful cousin, Kim Wallace. My cousin, Jaleel. And it's my cousin, Ricky, right there.
Yeah. Kim, how you doing, darling?
Fantastic.
Where you from?
I recently relocated here from Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Yeah, what you doing now?
I do whatever Kanye asked me to do. No.
It's a family business, you know. Somebody come up in the hood, you gotta take people with you. That's what it is. My man, how you feeling?
Pleasure.
Oh, is it Jaleel?
Yes, sir.
Jaleel,
yes, sir.
Good. This is the only family that ain't ever wore name tags.
What do you do, Jaleel?
I'm an architect.
Architect. Oh, okay, good. It's a little bit too heavy for me, so I'll just move on. Ricky, what's going on, man?
How you doing?
Good. Where you from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Good. What do you do?
I'm A&R for our record label.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to the show. So listen, y'all big fans of the show, you here, we happy to have you. This ought to be a lot of fun. Let's get it done, okay? Yeah. Y'all probably know who you're playing against. So let's just get it on. Let's go meet the Kardashian family. Hello, darling.
How are
this
you?
This is the matriarch, Kris Jenner, manages the careers of all six of her children. This woman right here know how to do it. She's a momager at the highest level, executive producer of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, and...
They keep me busy. They keep me hopping around here.
My wife's friend.
Love Marjorie.
That's
love. It. So beautiful.
How you been?
Good, really good. Now, I'm so excited to be here.
Yeah, now you're gonna notice you've never seen this before. One, two, three, four, five, six people over here. Because we've had a family feud backstage. Couldn't settle it, but we found out the perfect way to do it. So let's meet the real star of the show, introduce her.
This is my beautiful mother, Mary Jo, who we call MJ. Who's so excited to be here today.
So excited.
So Mary Jo is playing in tandem with Kris. That's it?
Yep,
we do not
do
have
great.
To explain to you why that is, because she was not gonna be on the show. I went and met her before. I've been a big fan of yours. I love you. Oh my God, you my favorite. So I said, she's going on TV. And you have to say that three times.
We all get it from somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, it starts right here.
All right, Kris, introduce everybody.
All right, well, next is my third oldest child, Khloe Kardashian. Yeah.
So how you doing?
Good, yeah. I'm excited to be here. We've been fighting.
Yeah.
You know? I'm ready for this feud. Me and Kim, I got you. Okay.
It's gonna be good. All right, next.
And then we have my fifth beautiful child, Kendall Jenner.
...2017's highest paid model in the world. Yes! Yes. Yes, and somehow I'm hoping against all odds that she finds one of my sons to be. Ooh, he fine. No, he not, but if you could just feel that. Got a clothing line with a sister called Kendall and Kylie. Very good. How are you?
I'm good.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Like they've all said, we're very excited to be here.
Good. So we glad to have you, too.
Thank you.
This is good. Who else we got?
All right, and then we have our beautiful cousin, Cece Bussey.
That's everybody's favorite cousin from their reality show, so that's
thank
it.
You. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Happy to be here.
Welcome
thank
to the
you.
Show.
And then we have everybody's favorite best friend, Jonathan Shevin.
I don't know who this woman is, but this means a lot to you somehow. She just went, oh my God, oh my God. So
oh,
this
no.
is it. And which charity are you playing for, Kris?
Children's Hospital of Los Angeles.
Okay, good.
Near and dear to our heart.
Folks, I knew this was gonna be a big surprise for you all. I told you, you know, this could be a big day for you. I was right. They're here. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. The band Perry won the game. It's time to play...
Dance Money!
Very good. All right, Kimberly, Reed is off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass.
Okay.
If you and Reed together come up with 200 points, look right there, tell everybody what you're playing for.
$25,000 for Teen Cancer America.
Yeah. You ready?
I hope so.
All right, 20 seconds on the clock, please.
We asked 100 married men, when you see your wife naked, what's she doing?
Taking a shower.
Name something people use to make a wish.
Star.
Name a place you've been to at 3 a.m.
A bar.
How many kisses does it take to know if there's any chemistry?
One.
Name something a bird only has two of.
Wings.
Wow. We asked 100 married men, when you see your wife naked, what's she doing? You said, taking a shower, survey said. Name something people use to make a wish. You said, star, survey said. Name a place you've been to at 3 a.m. You said, a bar, survey said. How many kisses does it take to know if there's any chemistry? You said, one, survey said. Name something a bird has only two of, you said. Two wings, survey said.
Wow.
What do I have to do?
Huh?
What do I have to do?
Well, you're gonna have to try not to be on YouTube.
Oh, God. Uh-oh.
God. What would be a big number you think she could get that would impress you?
200?
She tried.
She get close?
I don't know. I've only made, is, did somebody beat that once on the regular show?
Oh, yeah.
Let me think. I think that's really close to the top. I don't think I... She got 196.
Uh-huh. Yeah!
That's amazing. See, so all we left with now, Reed, is... Man. I'm gonna just go ahead and do it.
Uh-huh.
You know, you need 4.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you 5 questions. You only got to average 1 point.
Uh-huh. Okay. You realize you're setting me up for something really bad, too.
I hope not.
Yeah, me too, man.
I hope not, man, because first of all, I want the charity to win the money. But if you don't get this 4 points, mm-hmm. I can't even tell. Brother, you...
It's gonna be worse than my laying my head down answer that I gave over there, too.
Oh, no, this is gonna be way
past that one. Yeah. Before I got ragged on that one.
So let's just end it.
Okay.
I think you'll get it on the first one, and then it'll all be over.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. Okay. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. You give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, but how tough can it be? So we're gonna give you 25 seconds. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kimberly's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married men, when you see your wife naked, what's she doing?
Taking a shower.
Try again.
Getting dressed.
Name something people use to make a wish.
Wishing well.
Name a place you've been at 3 a.m.
A bar.
Try again.
Strip club.
How many...
not me.
My man. How many kisses does it take to know if there's any chemistry?
3.
Name something a bird only has 2 of.
Legs.
All right. We ask 100 married men, when you see your wife naked, what's she doing? You said, getting dressed. Uh-huh. Survey said,
yes!
Shower, shower and bathing, number one. Make a wish on a star, number one. A bar, number one. How many kisses? One, number one. Two of wings, number one. She had all number one answers. She had all of them. $25,000 for teen cancer. America, a veteran. All right, you ready?
Nope.
Okay. First time, that's threw me off a little bit, huh? Well, we're gonna put 20 seconds on the clock. All right, here we go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it.
Water.
Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married.
25.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year.
Flowers.
Name something children write with.
Crayons.
Name a way that Bigfoot's feet might be different from yours.
Huge.
Wow. Wow. Nice. Way to go, girl.
All right, let's go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it. You said, water. Survey said.
Yeah.
Tell me the age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married. You said, 25. Survey said.
Yeah.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year. You said, flowers, survey said. Yeah. Name something children write with, you said. Crayons, survey said. Yeah. Name a way that Bigfoot feet might be different from yours. You said, they're huge, survey said. Yeah. Oh. Okay, I'll tell you what. I got some good news and I got some bad news. Which one you want first?
I gotta go with the good news first.
Go with the good news. Your wife put up a really, really big number.
Okay.
Now here's the bad news. If you don't get this, you out the lead. Your ass. You need 6 points. For you, Steph, that's 2 shots.
Come on.
Step over half and let it go. Ready?
I guess so. Let's do it.
All right, let's remind everybody of Aisha's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it.
Water.
Try again.
Milk.
Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married.
25.
Try again.
30.
Name the same old gift husbands buy their wives year after year.
Pass.
Name something children write with.
Pencil.
Name a way that Bigfoot's feet might be different from your feet.
They're bigger.
Try again.
Hairier.
Yeah. That's good enough. Let's go. All right, let's go. We need 6 points. She nailed it. Name something you wish improved your memory every time you drank it. You said, milk.
Come on.
Survey said.
What?
Was it wine?
Alcohol, man. Alcohol.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Water. Water was the number one answer. Tell me what age a woman might say is the perfect age to get married. You said 30. Survey said. Thirty. was the number one answer. Flowers was the number one answer. Crayon was the number one answer. Bigger was the number one answer. She had all the number ones except for 30. $25,000 for the Community Foundation, Sonoma County. And I'd like to thank Steph and Chris and their families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. Stay tuned. We got two new families when Celebrity Family Feud continues. It's the Dunham family.
Thank you. All right, Steve.
Jim, how you doing, man?
All right. So wait, before we, you introduce us or I introduce them, there's somebody that wants to come out here and help. Okay. Well, hello, Steve.
Yeah, we've actually met before.
Yeah, we've met before. Some other show that you're on, too.
How old are you, man?
How old am I? It doesn't matter.
It doesn't?
You know you can't tell your age in show business because then you don't get parts.
Really?
Yeah, you know that. Anyway, Steve, I just want to come out here and say hi. I love the show.
Do you really?
I do. I love the show.
You know, why am I talking to him like he real, though? I'm so caught up. I'm like, I'm into this dude.
You know
man.
What? I feel the same way when talking to you, Steve. It's like you're actually there. So Walter wanted to come out here and help introduce the family. Is that all right?
That'll be perfect. Let's
okay,
do it.
Good. Okay, so how you do this? You go, hey, this is so-and-so, and just move down the line?
Well, I mean, Walter, you came out here, so don't you? Do you know everybody?
Do you think it was my idea to come out here, Steve?
I mean, but do you know these people?
Of course I do. What do you think? I paid for all their colleges.
I know the feeling. Well, what you do is just go down the line and just introduce each one of them one at a time.
Okay.
And you try to say something kind about people.
Oh, okay.
That ought to throw you
that
off.
That is a tough one for you, isn't it, Steve?
No, it's a tough one for you.
Okay, I got it. All right.
You're the angry old man.
I know. Well, you're going to be soon.
Pow!
Oh, you're funny.
Okay. Well, go ahead, Walter.
So, Walter, help us introduce. Okay, Steve, so right here, next to Jeff is Audrey, Jeff's lovely wife.
Yes.
Then his oldest daughter, Bree.
Hi, Bree.
Yeah. His middle daughter, Ashlyn.
Mm-hmm.
And on the end, the youngest little Kenna down there on the end. Jeff Turner.
Walter, you did that good, man.
Thanks, man. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for coming, man. Glad to have you again.
You know how I learned to do that? Just watching you, Steve.
Yeah. I teach a lot of people stuff. Hey, Walter. What charity are you playing for?
Oh, go ahead, Walter. You know this.
Yeah, well, Audrey told me. It's a baby to baby.
That's good.
Yeah, it is. It benefits kids that are from low-income families, and they get all the stuff that they need, like diapers and all the stuff for kids.
Great. Let's get it on. Give me Alex. Give me Luke. All right, fellas, here we go. Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 single men. Oh, this is gonna be a good one. Ladies, you're about to learn something. If you're dating more than one woman, you need to be really careful about what?
Your phone?
Yeah, your phone.
Yeah, baby.
You're doing
great.
Your phone. Alex.
Your other girlfriends?
Your other girl.
Damn. Alex knows.
Your other girlfriends. Pass or play?
Play. Play.
Woo. I was nervous.
Drew, talk to 100 single men. You're dating more than one woman. You need to be really careful about what?
Mixing up their names.
Mixing up their names.
Good. Wow, that was good.
Rory, oh, this is gonna be good, ladies.
Yeah.
Talk to 100 single men. If you're dating more than one woman, and all of you seem to be, you need to be really careful about what? right, Roy, we ask 100 single men, if you're dating more than one woman, you need to be really careful about what?
What gift you bought them.
What gift you bought them?
Come on, Matt.
All right, Craig, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. 5 seconds of summer, get ready to steal. Talk to 100 single men. If you're dating more than one woman, you need to really be careful about what?
Her friends.
Her friends.
It's good. Yeah. That's good.
Alex, two strikes, got to be careful.
Yeah.
Other team can steal.
Social media?
Social media, man. Yeah. Social media. Oh, yeah. All right, fellas. All right. Come on, man. We ask 100 single men. If you're dating more than one woman, you need to really be careful about what?
Committing.
Man, that is such a dude answer. Hey, you got more than one, you need to be careful about committing. Committing.
Oh! All right. Yes!
Yes! Number 8.
Woo! Yes, sir!
Cost budget.
6.
The cost?
Story straight.
4. Number 2. Let's go to question 2. Give me Drew. Give me Michael.
What's the word, turd?
Wow, you guys all got one liners. Yep. I didn't prepare mine. You suck.
I'm a songwriter.
Wow. All right, fellas, top 8 answers on the board. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Lottery ticket.
Lottery
The winning the lottery. Winning it.
Won't be no gambling in heaven, I don't think. Lottery ticket. Drew.
A halo.
A halo.
Yeah! Yeah!
Let's go. Let's go. Good job, baby. I'm gonna tell you again. All right, Roy, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Angel wings. Good.
Angel wings.
Yeah,
nice. Angel wings.
I got this.
Matt, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Food.
Food.
Come on, that's gotta be one. Yeah.
Food.
Yeah!
Craig, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
Like a pet or a dog?
A pet or a dog.
Yeah!
Okay, yeah.
Boom!
Okay, Alex, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A loved one.
Yeah. A loved one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, surreal. Yeah. A loved one. Hey, Drew, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A new car. I don't know.
Hey, hey.
A car. All right, Roy, name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
The answers.
That has to be one.
I know, right? Yeah. Come on.
The answers. All right, Matt.
Come on, boys.
We got 2 strikes. Got to be careful. 5 seconds of summer can steal. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
A jar of heaven. A jar of memories.
A jar of memories.
He's a songwriter. I have that. Come on.
A jar of memories.
The hell is that?
It's,
It's all I had, Alex. It's all I had.
It's God. He knows everything. He ain't putting nothing in jars.
Shouldn't have agreed to this today.
You're not gonna be in the band.
I know. Come on.
Jar of memories. All right, fellas, here's your chance. Name something you hope someone hands you the minute you get to heaven.
I just got to heaven. I want the coldest beer of all time.
A cold beer. Number 8.
Oh,
7. Got a good game. The goal was 200 points, so don't go away. We'll be back with more Celebrity Family Feud. Give me Daniel. Give me Boo Boo. All right, here we go. Point values are triple. Top 4 answers on the board. Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people that he's the best what?
Actor.
Best actor.
Okay.
Yeah.
So good, you guys.
Cheyenne?
Yes. Best dad.
Yes!
Best dad.
Yes!
Kenny, Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people that he's the best what?
Hey! Hey!
Dancer. Yeah. Ain't gonna be up there, but I like the move, though. Best dancer.
Oh.
Hey, Dub, only one strike. Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people that he's the best what?
Cook?
No, that's really true.
Yeah?
No, really.
Yeah,
I'm a bad boy.
Okay.
My country ass can cook. I'm barbecue boy now. Barbecue cook.
Yes.
Grill master. How did they know? Sophia, Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people. He's the best what?
Mentor.
He's the best mentor. Mentor. All right, Boo Boo, here we go. We got one answer left. But we got 2 strikes. If it's there, your family wins the game. But if it's not there this time, the other team can steal and they will win the game.
What?
Yeah.
No.
Yes, but they gotta steal though. Boo Boo, Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people that he's the best what?
Husband.
Yeah, I'm good husband. Steve Harvey's a pretty good husband.
Ready.
All right, here's the deal, family. You are a family.
Yeah, yeah.
If it's there, your team steals, your team wins the game. But if it's not there, Descendants 3 wins the game. Steve Harvey's kids might not tell him, but you know they brag to other people that he's the best what?
Author.
He is the best author. Number 3.
Liar.
Yeah, that ain't no lie. Hey, man, hope you had a good time.
Yeah.
Great.
That's amazing.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Hope y'all had a good time. Thank you, guys. Hey! I need two of you to play Fast Money. Come on, I got the girls. I got Dove and I got Sophia. We want to thank American Housewives for playing. We're going to make a donation to your foundation just for coming along. Hey, y'all, we'll be right back. We're going to play Fast Money with the ladies right after this. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. Team Ninja won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
All right, Chris. Ninja's off stage. I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Ninja together come up with 200 points. Look right there, tell them what you're playing for.
$25,000 for Stack Up!
Yeah! Come on, baby, let's go. All right, you ready? 20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married women, when your husband has a night out with the boys, tell me something he comes home smelling of.
Booze.
After how many days is leftover pizza still good?
5.
Give me a word that rhymes with blimp.
Pimp.
Name something a man might put on his meatballs.
Gravy.
Name someone grandma has a picture of on her nightstand.
Her son.
All right, let's go. We ask 100 married women, when your husband has a night out with the boys, tell me something he comes home smelling of. You said, booze, survey said. Woo! Yeah. After how many days is leftover pizza still good? You said,
5.
Wow.
I don't cook a lot, Steve.
Wow. Survey said? Give me a word that rhymes with blimp. You said? My man. Come on, boy. Pimping ain't easy, but somebody gotta do it. Might as well be me. Survey said? Name something man might put on his meatballs. You said gravy. Survey said.
I'll take it.
Name someone grandma has a picture of on her night table. You said her son. Survey said. Ninja, I got good news for you.
Thank God.
Chris got 139 points. Come on, Ninja. We need 61 points for the money for Stack Up. All right, let's remind everybody of Chris's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 married women, when your husband has a night out with the boys, tell me something he comes home smelling of.
Alcohol.
Try again.
Smoke.
After how many days is leftover pizza still good?
2.
Give me a word that rhymes with blimp.
Pimp. Gimp.
My man, yeah. Name something a man might put on his meatballs.
Sauce.
Name someone grandma has a picture of on her night table.
Her son.
Try again.
Her lover.
Come on, man.
Ooh, I mean, grandpa is lover.
Yeah. You better hope he is. We need 61 points for the money. We ask 100 married women, when your husband has a night out with the boys, tell me something he comes home smelling of. You said, smoke, survey said. Yeah. Beer and alcohol was the number one answer. 33 points away. After how many days is leftover pizza still good? You said 2 days, your buddy's eating it 5 days later. Survey said. Woo! 2 was the number one answer. 5 points away from the money. give me a word that rhymes with blimp. You first said pimp. Naturally. I love your thinking, yeah, man. Yeah. You said gimp. Survey said.
I hope it's not up there.
Don't worry. Oh! Limp was the number one answer. Name something a man might put on his meatballs. You said sauce. Survey said boom. Spaghetti sauce was number one. Kids and grandkids was number one. Well, that's $25,000 for Stack Up. I want to thank Ninja and Juju and their families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. Stay tuned. We're going to have two new families when we come back playing more Celebrity Family Feud. Yeah, let's make it happen. Woo. All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. How many pounds would you need to lose on a diet before you'd brag about it?
20.
Name something you use to catch a fish.
A hook.
What part of your body does the word thick best describe?
Thighs.
Name someone a woman might rely on for advice.
Best friend.
Name a color rabbits come in.
White.
Damn.
Wow. I'm trying, oh God.
All right, here we go. How many pounds would you need to lose on a diet before you brag about it? You said 20, survey said.
Five.
Yeah.
Okay.
Name something you use to catch a fish. You said, need a hook, survey said.
All right.
What part of your body does the word thick best describe? Yes, Lord. You said.
Thick thighs, save lives.
Survey said.
All right.
Name someone a woman might rely on for advice. You said. Best friend, survey said.
Yes, Lord.
Name a color rabbits come in, you said. White, survey said. Come on, Israel. Israel, your wife got 176 points. You need 24 points for $25,000.
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Adrian's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. How many pounds would you need to lose on a diet before you'd brag about it?
25.
Name something you use to catch a fish.
A hook.
Try again.
Bait.
What part of your body does the word thick best describe?
Stomach.
Name someone a woman might rely on for advice.
Pass.
Name a color rabbits come in.
Gray.
Name someone a woman might rely on for advice.
Best friend.
Try again.
Her mother.
Mother. There we go. Let's go. All right, let's see. How many pounds would you need to lose on a diet before you'd brag about it? You said a 25, survey said. 20. 20 was the number one answer. Wally 14 away. Name something you use to catch a fish. You said you need some bait. Survey said. Boom, right there. That's it, boy. All right. Fishing pole was the number one answer. Belly and waist was the number one answer. A woman's friend is the number one answer. White rabbit, number one answer. That's $25,000 for Global Gift Foundation USA. We're gonna send a lot of love out to Puerto Rico. I'd like to thank Adrian and Allie and AJ and the families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. All right, here we go. What percent of the work does the husband do in the delivery room?
10.
Fill in the blank. Pony blank.
Express.
Name something you might drink a glass of.
Water.
Name something a person's belly does.
Shake.
Name something about Steve Harvey the Sharp.
It's mine.
Let's get it.
All right, let's go. All right, what percent of the work does the husband do in the delivery room? You said 10%. Survey said? All right, fill in the blank. Pony blank. You said? Express. Survey said? All right. Name something you might drink a glass of. You said? Water. Survey said? Yeah. Name something a person's belly does. You said? Shake. Survey said? Yeah. Name something about Steve Harvey that's sharp. And you said, that boy mine.
Hell yeah.
I know that's right. Pow. You the first contestant I done ever did that to.
Better.
I know that's right. Survey said, oh yeah.
Great job. Great job.
Sugar Slim, listen to me. Marjorie got 163 points.
Ooh.
You need 37, son. Ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Marjorie's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, son. What percent of the work does the husband do in the delivery room?
10.
Try again.
20.
Fill in the blank. Pony blank.
Horse.
Name something you might drink a glass of.
Water.
Try again.
Milk.
Name something a person's belly does.
Jiggles.
Try again.
Bounces.
Names. Try again.
Pass.
Name something about Steve Harvey the Sharp.
Mustache.
Name something a person's belly does.
Tucks in their pants. I don't know.
Let's go, here we go. What percent of the work does the husband do in the delivery room? You said 20%. Survey said? 0. 0% is the number one answer. That's the number one you missed.
Yeah, yeah.
Fill in the blank.
Yeah. That one.
Pony blank. You said the pony horse. Horse. Survey said.
Yeah. Pony ride.
Number one answer was pony tail.
Ah.
Name something you might drink a glass of. You said, hold me, son, this is going bad. Milk. Survey said.
Let's go.
Water was the number one answer. Name something a person's belly does. You said, tucks in their pants.
Yeah, you gotta. Yeah, you know, just push
it. There.
Survey said.
No.
Oh, Lord.
Okay, mustache.
You got this. Come on, mustache.
Growls. Growls is number one. Growl. Ah, ah.
Growl.
Name something about Steve Harvey that's sharp. You said mustache.
I'm trying all to get this, like you.
I know, all these damn clothes I buy.
Yep.
Survey said.
Oh!
Wit and mind was the number one answer. Come on, you ready to have a good time? All right, let's go. Let's get it on. Give me Lance. Give me Kelly. Let's go.
I love you.
I'd like to shake my booty.
Yeah.
All right.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I'm gonna like do your.
Two hands or one?
I don't know. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Y'all, okay, one hand.
Here we go.
Okay, hold on.
Pull yourself together. Come on, let's have this moment here. Come on. Let's get on into it.
You're gonna this have is to subtitle this episode. We're so Southern.
This is it. This is your okay. moment here. Okay, nice shoes like that.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Okay, hold on.
Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name something specific that only your man is allowed to do to your behind. Okay. You scared the shit out of me.
This is like reinforced here.
No. What the hell had happened? I thought you was falling. I went. Okay. Lance.
Yes. Give it a little pinch.
Give it a little pinch.
That's right.
Kelly.
I should say it.
Yeah, you do. Just
gotta
do it.
Say it.
Like a little spank. Oh, yeah. A little pat.
Give it a little spank.
Thank you.
And for those of y'all that ain't from the country, she said spank. Give it a little spank. Two syllables from us in the country. Spank. But it's just spank.
My translator.
Give it a little spank. Yeah, we're gonna play. We're gonna play. James.
Come on, Steven, where are you?
Where was I? No, I'm the host. I'm the host. Steve don't do no right. I done seen this before. You don't get in the middle of heavyweights when they doing what they do. They hit too hard. If they accidentally hit you, it's gone. It's Christmas. It's Christmas. We ain't even had Easter yet. It's Christmas. All right, let's go, fellas. Point values are double. We got the top six answers on the board. We ask 100 men, name something you do when you realize you run out of clean underwear. James.
Clean up and get new ones. Buy some new ones.
It doesn't matter the new ones.
Buy some new ones.
I got you. You can buy some new ones.
Ray? Go commando.
Go commando.
We're playing.
We're gonna play. Yeah. Ooh, I was scared. This could have went so bad. Huh? I was talking about hell, I can't whoop nobody up here. I was gonna try to point to somebody, but I can't whoop nobody up here.
Steve, you can't whoop nobody over here, but over there, no problem.
No, Jen, there might be no problem for you. I can't whoop nobody over here. You can't cash that check.
You can take the check over there and cash it.
Where's the bank? What bank?
Don't worry, Steve. You safe. You safe, Steve. We got your back, baby. Don't worry about
you
it.
You do. You got my back. You got my back, gang.
I got always in the back.
Because he the... Come on, Ray. Please don't. Please don't get him started. It's a nice family gang, kids is watching. I gotta.
Ooh.
Y'all supposed to huddle up. Well, don't worry about it. Don't.
Oh my God. This is nice.
Boy, do I miss just regular old families. Oh, man. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud. Let's play Fast Money with Marseille. All right, now, Miles is off stage, Marseille. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Miles together come up with 200 points. Look right there, tell them what you're playing for.
$25,000 for Color of Change.
Yes. There you go, young lady. All right, you ready?
Yes.
All right, let's go. 20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 men, name a superhero outfit it might be fun to wear on Hollywood Boulevard.
Wonder Woman.
Tell me how many more dollars a week you wish you earned.
Pass.
Name something you put in your mouth every day.
Gum.
Name something a person might be referring to when they say great catch.
Baseball.
Name a flavor of frosting.
Flakes.
Tell me how many dollars a week you wish you earned. Let me read that. Tell me how many more dollars a week you wish you earned.
$10,000.
Yeah!
Regular America!
You did great, sweetheart. You did great.
Here we go, darling.
You did great, Kayla.
We asked 100 men, name a superhero outfit it might be fun to wear on Hollywood Boulevard. You said, I can't tell you how true that is. Survey said, tell me how many more dollars a week you wished you earned. I love this answer. You said, just 10,000. That'll tighten it up. Everybody in the room quit breathing. Survey said.
Yeah.
Name something you put in your mouth every day. You said, gum. Survey said. Name something a person might be referring to when they said great catch. You said baseball. Survey said. Yeah. Name a flavor of frosting. You said.
I don't know what I said. Flakes.
Frosted flakes.
Frosting flakes?
That's a kid. That's a kid. Frosted flakes. Read
the
box on your desk.
Chocolate, vanilla.
Survey said. All right, let's go. Yeah. All right, Miles, man, you're gonna have to put your thinking cap on here. We need a little help to get this one home. You need a lot of points, okay? Mm-hmm. You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's remind everybody of Marseille's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, little man, let's go at it. We asked 100 men, name a superhero outfit it might be fun to wear on Hollywood Boulevard.
Batman.
Tell me how many more dollars a week you wish you earned.
100.
Name something you put in your mouth every day.
Food.
Name something a person might be referring to when they say great catch.
Pass.
Name a flavor of frosting.
Vanilla.
Name something people refer to when they say great catch.
Football! You said you could win this for us, Miles.
He did great.
But you said you
he did great.
You did better than me, I'm sorry.
They both did great.
I did better than you, Kaylin. I need play.
We
he
see
is
what kind
not
of
a good father.
Is. You guys were amazing.
Yeah.
Yes,
thank
you were.
For
you were.
Yeah. Thank you, Tracy. Thank you so much for coming. Can't stand his ass.
You are great.
Evil ass daddy. We need 166 points. We asked 100 men, name a superhero outfit it might be fun to wear on Hollywood Boulevard. You said, Batman, survey said. Superman
nice,
was the number
it.
One
I
answer.
I knew it.
Tell me how many more dollars a week you wish you earned. You said, 100, survey said. $1,000 was the number one answer. need to up your dreams. Name something you put in your mouth every day. You said, let's get right at it. Food, survey said. Yeah. Toothbrush. Toothbrush was the number one answer. And that's not true. Name something a person might be referring to when they say great catch.
Football!
Number one answer, a fish.
What? Oh, okay.
A fish. Oh. Name a flavor of frosting you said.
Flakes!
Vanilla. Survey said. Boom. Chocolate. Chocolate was the number one answer. Well, that's okay. We're also gonna give $10,000 to your foundation, Color of Change. I wanna thank Anthony and Jeff and the rest of you for coming out on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.